everyone, and welcome to my studio. I'm Linda Peterson. It's time for another Spellbinders Media Mixage video, and today we're going to be working with bezels, dies, texture plates, and metal to create a cute little mini art journal. These are the Spellbinders dies that we'll be using to complete our project today. First, I have the Rectangles 2 die. This is the number 3, with 1 being the smallest, and it's what we will use to create our book cover and book pages. These other two we'll be using to embellish the cover. I have the Ovals 1, the number 1, or the smallest, and I have the Butterfly here from the Jewels Flower and Flourishes collection. We're going to begin by creating the book cover first from the sheet of aluminum metal from the Spellbinders Media Mixage line, and we'll be using our rectangle die. You'll use the exact same sandwich as you would if you were cutting out paper. So you'll have the cutting plate, your material, followed by your die, and then your base plate. Now pass this sandwich through the Artisan Explorer to cut out the rectangle book cover. You're going to do this exact same step, except this time with paper. I've chosen some dictionary pages, and I've cut out around 20 different rectangle pieces, which will later become the book pages. So you'll cut out one rectangle from the metal and about 20 rectangles from paper. Next, we're going to add some texture to our book cover using the texture plates. I'm using the Great Works 2 pattern. It's a gorgeous pattern. And because the aluminum is a softer metal than the brass blanks, our sandwich will be slightly different. We'll still use the base plate A, but this time the texture plate is facing up. Add the metal rectangle and secure it with tape. Cover it with the embossing mat and close the sandwich with the embossing plate. Now pass this sandwich through the Artisan Explorer and look at the beautiful detail you have on your book cover. As you can see here, I've already begun distressing the cover with a Copic marker. Now you can distress in any way you want, using paint or ink, but I particularly like the alcohol markers because they dry quickly. I also like to use a sanding sponge to reveal some of the texture and add more interest. On the back side, I've drawn two lines. One inch from the edge, and the second 1¼ inches from the edge. Use the side of a ruler or a straight edge, and bend the metal at the lines to form your book. It should look similar to this. To create the pages in the book, I've gathered a few pages here and I folded them in half, given them a nice little crease line, and then I've stapled along the crease line to make a signature. Now I gathered the signatures together, and you'll add a little bit of glue along the edges of the signature and allow them to dry. Once they're dry, then you can glue your pages into your book. There are so many possibilities and different ways you can embellish the front cover of your book, and I encourage you to explore beyond. I've used a bezel here from the Ovals 1 5-pack along with the corresponding die to cut out an image from the Ephemera Pages 1 book, and I've placed that image inside the oval bezel. I've also distressed the bezel a little bit with a dab of paint around the outer edges just to give it a shabby chic look. I cut a butterfly from bronze metal. I distressed it and I cut it in half. And then I separated the wings a little bit and glued them to the back of the bezel. As you can see in the finished piece here, I added additional texture to the front cover with some lace. I glued my bezel to the front cover and I made some danglies with beads and chain. On this piece, I attached a brooch pin to the back of it. For another idea, I turned the mini album into a pendant. And this time I used a vintage photo of my grandma. I drilled a hole in the bottom corner and I added some decorative chain and vintage style charms. I used extra long silk cords that I'll tie in the back of the neck so I can adjust the length. The Spellbinders Media Mixage line makes it so easy to create beautiful mixed media works of art. So be sure to check out the entire line on their website at spellbinderscreativearts.com. That's going to wrap it up for this episode, but I'll be back to share more mixed media videos with you and more ideas and techniques. Until then, remember, the possibilities are endless when you explore beyond.